What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the blog. Today I have another review for you. I'm gonna be pulling out the Renogy Inverter Charger 2000 watt model. Super stoked, go over it with you guys. Bit of an unboxing, not actually because I've already taken it out of the box, but I'm gonna go over everything that was included in the box, and then I'm gonna go over the details of it, what it looks like, how to install it. Yeah, let's get to it. Gonna go grab it because it's a beast. Oh. Yep, don't break the table. Okay, so this is the inverter charger. It is a pure sine inverter, 2000 watts, and it's about 60 pounds. So it is not light and it is not small, but most of these inverter chargers aren't, no matter what model or brand you purchase. This guy is used two main purposes. One is going to be charging the batteries off of shore power. The other is going to be inverting from 12 volts to 120. We'll use this to power two outlets we have, one in the kitchen and one right down here. We'll also be able to hook into shore power, which will be really nice when we pull into campgrounds. I have a 30 amp outlet that I'm going to be installing on the outside of the van. The reason I went with the 2000 watt is because I think that'll be plenty for us. We only have the two outlets. If you wanted to go with the 3000 watt, that would be for a lot larger power sources. One of the big ones is a conventional stove, which we didn't go with. We went with a propane stove. So that'll save us in quite a bit of power. That was one of my goals throughout this build, is I wanted to limit the amount of power that we would be using, just so you don't have to spend thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars on lithium batteries, because that's something that I didn't want to do. Renogy didn't supply this, so this is 100% my perspective and overview of this product. I'm really excited to install it. I've heard good things about it, so I don't know how I'm gonna install it or mount it, but leave that to future me. We'll figure it out. But yeah, let's go over all the connection points and what you get in the box. Okay, so I know this has already been brought out of the box, but this is also what you get inside. Owner's manual. Renogy stickers, of course. Right here, you have a battery temperature sensor. And then here is just a remote on off switch, which you can plug in to this guy, run it somewhere else, so you don't have to go back to turn it on and off when you want to do that, which I'll probably be installing somewhere under the seat. I'm gonna go ahead and take off some of the screws that hold on this front cover so I can get to the connections here. So after you move all like 1,000 screws, I'm just kidding, but actually there's like 10 screws that you have to unscrew to get these covers off. This top piece just slides out like that. And then this whole front piece slides out. Just turn this around. Give you guys a point of view. All right, so what we have here is negative battery, positive battery, temperature sensor, and then you have some data ports. And then over here is where you have your in and out for your AC power. It's super simple and easy. And then up here you have your LCD screen. Most of Renogy's products have been really straightforward, great for DIYers like me. And if you're watching this video, I'm sure you're looking at doing this yourself too. Solar systems aren't exactly self-explanatory. They can be pretty complex. So it's nice to be able to have support, which is one thing I've had trouble with Renogy with, actually. I did want to order one of their batteries, and if you're in the United States, I've heard good things about contacting customer service, but internationally, like me in Canada, it's hard to get a hold of them. Their number doesn't work. It's always busy,
They don't put you on hold. It just rings once and then goes busy. I've emailed them multiple times. The odd email I get like a response back. So to be honest, it was really frustrating for me. I did go with like a lot of their products, but I'm a little worried in the future if I have trouble with them, not gonna be able to get the support I want. That's why I ended up sending, I never even got the battery. They just canceled the order after 2 months of me not receiving it. I went to Canbat, which is actually a local company out of Vancouver. They specialize in lithium batteries and they actually have a cold temperature model, which is awesome, especially if you're gonna be skiing in your van, doing winter activities like we're gonna be, or you live in Canada and wanna use it in the winter. Let me know in the comments if you want me to do an install video on this. I plan on doing an install video on everything, which is what I'm gonna get to right away here. And I am super excited to see how it all works and let you guys know how it all works if I have any problems. If you like this video, give it a like, subscribe to the channel, check out some of the other videos I've done. I'm going to be reviewing the Canbat lithium battery, 200 amp hours. I also already reviewed the 50 amp DC to DC charger with MPPT. Check that one out. I'll see you in the next one.